If my screen is visible. No, ma'am.
Yes, allowed.
My screen is
Visible, ma'am, visible.
So good afternoon to everyone. Today we are going to see about a keyboard display controller, which is Intel 8279. It is a peripheral device used to interface the keyboard and display to the microprocessor or microcontroller. It is mainly used for 8085 and 8086 as a peripheral devices. So, features of 8279. Hi. We can simultaneously at the same time we can use the keyboard and display at the same time with the help of 8279. So it is a 40 pin IC. It has different modes. First is a keyboard mode, and another is sensor mode. It supports the keyboard from 64 key matrix, and with the two options, we can see that in further slides. So these are some of the features of 8279, and it has one FIFO buffer, which is first in, first out buffer. So what are the characters? First it comes, it will be stored in that buffer. So this is the pin diagram of 8279. It has a 40 pin IC. We have 8 pin for output. So we have a 8 pin for data bus. This is bidirectional in. So we have eight pin data bus. These lines are used for communicating with the microprocessor and microprocessor 8279, where we can send the data and receive the data from microprocessor with the help of this DB02 DB7. Next, we have a read and write pin. So we can first we have A0 pin. A0 pin, this indicates the transfer. If this is enabled, if this is pin is high, we can transfer the control board to the if this is low, we can transfer the data between the microprocessor and the 8279. If this is high, the microprocessor will send some control word to the 8275. This is the function of A0 bit. And BD is the active low bit. If this is low, it blanks the display. If we connect the display to 8279, we can totally reset that display with the help of the BD pin, clock pin. Here it has this clock pin is used to generate some internal timing for scanning the key lines. It is used for the clock pin is used for that. And CN and ST. This is a control and strobe mode pin. In this, it is normal like our keyboard, it's a control pin. So for keyboard mode, this is used as a control input. Its status is also stored along with the key position or key closure. So it has, so it is used to attach a control key with the 8079 and chip select. If this pin is low, it allows the read and write operations to be transferred to the microprocessor. And the DB0 to DB7 is the data bus line. It's a bi-directional line where we can read the data to microprocessor. The microprocessor will read the data from 8073, or also it can write the data with the help of DB0. This and other pins are IRQ. IRQ is interrupt request pin. It is provide a request signal to the microprocessors indicating for the next data to transfer. So when the key is pressed, it will request a microprocessor to transfer that key into data. So this pin will be used as interrupt request. Next, out A3 to A0 and B0 to B3. This can be used at 2 4-bit for connecting so it can be used as 2 4-bit or 1 8-bit port that can be used to connect a display, 7-segment display or LCD display. And this pin can be encoded or decoded with the help of a decoder circuit. And shifter, like the control key, this shift key is an additional key used to connect a keyboard. And SL3 to SL0 is a scan line output, which scan the keyboard as well as display. Whenever the key is pressed, this scan line will scan if it is pressed or not. This is the internal architecture of block diagram of 8079. So it this architecture contains of 4 sections. So it contains of 4 sections: keyboard section, display section, scan section, and CPU microprocessor section. So this data buffer, control time register, and timing control will be in the CPU interface section. And this FAFO sensor, RAM sensor, keyboard, debounce, and control, written, this will be in the keyboard section. And here display, address register, display RAM, display register will be in the display section. And the scan counter and the sensor RAM will be in the scan section. We see about the keyboard section. So this section includes a 8x8 FAFO buffer, first in and first out. FAFO RAM consists of 8 registers that can store 8 keyboard entries. So each is then read in the order of entries. It has a debounce circuit. If the key is pressed, it automatically debounces, which means okay, it contains 8 return lines RL0 to RL7, which we previously seen in pin diagram. This RL0 to RL7 is used to return the status of the key if it is pressed or not to the microprocessor. It has a 2 additional inputs like shift key and the control key. These keys are automatically debounced, which means if we press it automatically, this can be pressed at once. So after that, we have to press it again, that is debounced. So it has a mainly important 2 operating modes, which is 2-key lockout and N-key rollover. 2-key lockout mode is if we simulate it, if we have pressed a two key at the time, same time if we press a two key, the first key will be taken into the FIFO buffer. Second will be second will cannot consider as it will leave out. This is the two key lockout mode. In N key loader mode, if simultaneously we at the same time we can test number of keys so that can be stored in FIFO. The difference between is two key lockout mode, only one key is recognized in the FIFO buffer, the other key will not. And in N key, the simultaneous key can be recognized and taken into FIFO buffer. So next we are moving to display section. Display section consists of 8 output, which is A0 to A3 and B0 to B3. This can be act as 4-bit to 2 4-bit or 8-bit port to connect display to A279. So BD pin will be used to blank the device. Scan section. Scan section. This section has a scan counter and 4 scan lines, which is SL0 to SL3. These lines can be decoded by 4 to 16 decoder to generate 16 lines for scanning. The scan lines is common for both the section, the keyboard and the display section. The scan lines are very common. It's the CPU interface section. In this CPU interface section, we have that 8-bit bi-directional data links, which we can transfer the data between A279 and CPU. And when A0 bit 1 is 0, it will select the data buffer and we can transfer the data from A279 and CPU. If A1 is 1, it will use it to control the control register of A279. Which we can either we can operate in different modes of operation. So control signals, if write, these are the pins used to read and write in the control register. So the internal clock frequency of A279 is 100 kilowatts. We can it can be increased by using the clock pin. These are the different operating modes. So of A279, we have two major modes, input mode and output mode. In input mode, we have a scanned keyboard mode. This mode can be used as encoder or decoder scan. In encoder, so in encoder, we have a in encoder we have 8x8 keyboard, which means 128 characters can be recognized by using this mode, and in decoder 4x8 keyboard, which means 32 characters can be recognized. When this key is pressed in this mode, this will be directly stored in FIFO RAM. And the scan sensor matrix, it is used to connect a sensor array which map 8x8 keyboard to scan that key if it is pressed or not, which in this mode can be used. And strobe input mode, in this mode, the data storing in the FIFO buffer can be stored as byte by byte. So this is the output mode. In output mode, we have a display scan and display entry. In display mode, we have left entry mode and right entry mode. Left entry mode is example typewriter. We the data will be entered in left to right, and in right entry mode it will be in like calculator, the data will be in the entry from right to left. So this is the controller, this control register by to select the different types of mode. This DD bit is used for display, that 00, if you give 00, 8 digit display with left entry will be used as function, and 01 for 16 digit display, and 10 for 8 digit display, and 11 for 16 digit display with right entry. And this 3M is used for keyboard mode. In keyboard mode, if you want to use 2 key lock code encoded, we use this 000. And 001 decoded keyboard with 2 key lock code. 010 encoded keyboard with N key rollover, and 011 decoded keyboard with N key rollover. And 110 we can use in sensor matrix encoder or decoder with these 010 and 101. And a strobe mode we can encode given by 101. And thank you. That's all.
Completed, Alauddin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for presenting this seminar. Okay. Students, do you have any doubts regarding this? So let me summarize important points involved in keyboard and display session. Actually, 8279 is an Intel product. It is a 40-pin LSI device. Which is used to interface both keyboard and multiplex display session to the microprocessor 8085 and 8086. Actually, it supports keyboard of size up to 64 key matrix with two options, that is 2 key lockout and N key rollover. And also it supports display interface of up to 16 device. So at a time we can display 16 device by using this interfacing IC, and also it has a built-in hardware for key debouncing operation. Okay, so these are some important features, and the main thing is it has 8-byte FIFO RAM. So whenever the key is pressed, the corresponding hex code will be stored in FIFO RAM. It's a buffer. It can hold 8-byte data at a time, and also some cases for display cases, it provides 16-byte RAM to store 16 digits of display data, okay? And also supports simultaneous keyboard and display operation, okay? And the four major sections of 8279 are keyboard session, scan section, display, and microprocessor interface session. Alauddin, can you project that block diagram? Diagram of 8279. Just I will summarize some important points related to that. So this is the block diagram of your 8279. So we have four major sessions. Four major sessions. One is keyboard, and second one is the scan session, and third one is display session, and fourth one is the microprocessor interface session. Okay. In keyboard session, so left side you can see it includes 8x8 FIFO buffer or sensor. Okay, we have 8x8 first in first out RAM, and also this RAM consisting of 8 register that can store 8 keyboard entries. Okay, so each is then read in the order of entries. And also it has some debug and control circuit, keyboard debug and control circuit, in which the keys are automatically debounced, okay? So the status logic keep tracks of logic entries and provide interrupt request signal when FIFO is not empty. So that is the concept. So in your case, that is the keyboard section, we have 8x8 FAFO buffer and keyboard debounce and control. So this keyboard can operate in two modes. One is two key lockout, other one is the N key rollover. So two key lockout, in this mode, two keys are pressed simultaneously. Only one key is recognized by your 8279. So it's a very important mode, operating modes of 8279. Please make note of it. Two key rollout means when two keys are pressed simultaneously, the only one key is recognized by 8279. N key rollover mode, in this mode, simultaneous keys are recognized and their codes are stored in internal FAFO buffer. Okay. And also we have 7 return lines that are connected to the column of your matrix, the column of your keyboard or keypad. Okay. And scan section, the scan counter, please look at that scan counter. We have a SL0 to SL3. Okay. So these lines can be decoded by 4 to 16 decoder to generate 16 lines for scanning. That's also only purpose of scanning your keys, the keyboard or keypad. And display session, we have 8 lines divided into 2 groups. Your rightmost side, okay, sorry, leftmost side, 8 output lines divided into 2 groups, that is A0 to A3 and B0 to B3. Okay. There are used as group of 8 lines or group of 4 lines in conjunction with scan lines for multiplexed display, okay. And fourth important block, your microprocessor interface. So here we have 8 data lines, that is DB0 to DB7, and 1 interrupt request line, and 6 lines for interfacing, that is read bar, write bar, CS for A0. So these signals were already we have discussed in your 8255 and 8259. Okay, your read bar, write bar. Almost the functions are very similar to your 8255 and 8259 IC. Only the difference is it is included with your keyboard and display. Okay. So A0 is the buffer address line, and that is only for your device internal selection. And IRQ lines goes high means whenever the data entries are stored in, that is goes high whenever the data entry is stored in FAFO. That is mainly it is used to interrupt your microprocessor to indicate the availability of data. So this is the overall your block diagram of 8279. And also Alauddin has explained all the pin details, that is your data bus, chip select, reset, clock, buffer address line, A0, read bar, write bar, and interrupt request. Okay. Allow them, please stop presenting your screen. So here I am going to explain how to interface four keypad with 8051 microcontroller, and also how to display the pressed key on LCD 16x2. Okay. So keyboard interfacing means that is keyboard are organized in a matrix of rows and column. That is your matrix keyboard. Consists of a set of push button or switches which are arranged in a matrix format of column and rows. Okay. So CPU can access both rows and columns through ports. Okay. CPU access both row and columns through ports of your 8051 or 8086 or 8085 processor. So therefore, 2 8-bit ports and 8x8 matrix of key can be connected to microprocessor. Suppose your keyboard sizes, keypad sizes, 8x8 means it requires 2 8-bit port to interface your keypad with microprocessor. Okay. Normally here all the columns are connected to the input pins. I will explain that later. Suppose when a key is pressed means the row and column make a contact. Okay. when key is pressed, row and column make a contact. Otherwise, there is no connection between rows and columns. So this is the logic we are going to use in our program. So whenever the key is pressed, there is a contact between your row and column. When while scanning that contact, we can easily trace out the key press. Okay. So look at this diagram. So here we have two ports, port 1 and port 2. So port 1, that is all the rows of your this keypad is 8x8 keypad, okay. So 4x4. 4 rows, 4 columns. Okay, so 4 rows, D0, D1, D2, D3. Okay, so these 4 lines are connected to port 1. Okay, and columns we have 4, D0, D1, D2, D3 are connected to port 3. So status of each key can be determined by process called scanning. So let's assume all the column pins. So consider this is CO1, CO2, CO3, CO4, 4 columns, okay. So all the column pins are connected to the input pins and all the row pins are connected to the output pin. So you have to make this P1 as output, P2 as input, okay. Is that clear? So all the column pins are connected to input pins and all the row pins are connected to the output pins of the microcontroller. Okay. So suppose here, please look at the statement. If all the rows are grounded, a key is pressed, one of the column will have 0. Suppose this key is pressed, when 2 is pressed, D2 becomes 0. Which means that the key available on this column CO3 is pressed. So using scanning technique, it will scan 2, 6, A, E. Suppose if the switch is pressed, means it will receive logic low signal. So using that signal, your microcontroller or microprocessor will recognize the pressed key. That is the column. That is the concept. So if all the rows are grounded and a key is pressed, that case one of the column will have 0. Using that 0, it will proceed with scanning process. Individually, it will check each row value. When the pressed key receives logic low, means that key will be reflected in your microcontroller data bus. Is that clear? So 4 rows, 4 columns. So columns are connected to input pins. Rows are connected to output pins. Suppose this key is pressed, means your column 2 receives 0. And it will process the keys available in each row. Based on this contact, here your output will be 0. So which means that this key is pressed. Okay, this process is called scanning process. So please make down the important points, note down the important points. So the keyboard continuously scanning the switches, that is both your row and column contact. Suppose when the key is pressed, means your output of the column will be 0. The pressed column, whenever the key is pressed, means the corresponding column will be 0. So here, one of the column bits has 0, means that means the key press has occurred. So for example, D3 to D0, so which column is enabled here? D1 is enabled. That means a key in D1 column has been pressed. So microcontroller will go through the individual rows and identify the key. So you can clearly understand the concept by using this example. So here first example D3-02 D0, this is 1110, that is your D0 is selected here, D0 selected. That is this row will be selected. And next column case, your D2 output will be 0. This will be 0. So this column is selected. Okay. So when the key is pressed means your D0 receives, that is your D2 receives 0 and it will raise the keys. Okay. From this row, next one, next and next. So the row belongs to D0 and column belongs to D2. So therefore this key is pressed. The key number 2 was pressed. So the row and column of the pressed key D3 to D0 is 110. Okay. So your D0 is 0. That is your first row will be selected. And that case when 2 is pressed means your column output will be D2 output will be 0. So it will scan 2, 6, A and E. If the key is pressed means your 2, this switch receives logic 0. Based on the output, the key is traced. So here key number 2 was pressed. And next case D3 to D0, 1101. So which row was selected here? D1 is selected. So this row was selected. And your column output is, which column is selected? Your D3 column is selected. So based on the selection, we can trace out the 7th one, your key number. Therefore, your key number 7 was pressed. So according to this, which row was selected? D1 is selected. According to this column, D3 will be selected. So tracing this, scanning the process from top to bottom, your key 7 was pressed based on the contact between row and column. Is that clear? Is it clear? Any doubts in this example? So first case, your row 1 is selected, that is D0 is selected. This row is selected. Okay. When the switch is pressed, there is a contact between row and column. Based on the contact, your D2 becomes 0. So based on the scanning process, the programming, it will scan the switch individually. On D2 column. So when 2 is pressed means it will make contact between row and column so that it will receive logic 0. So your microprocessor will identify this. So next I'm going to explain the coding part of this 4x4 matrix keyboard. Okay. So here logic low is given to row 1 and others are high. So the algorithm is, so here you can see these are rows. We have 4 rows and these 4 rows are connected to the 8051 or 8086 microcontroller, microprocessor and microcontrollers. We have 4 columns. So this one is configured as output. There is rows are configured as output and columns are configured as input. Okay. So first logic low is given to row 1. Okay. Row 1. Others are high. Okay. So each column is scanned. If switches belongs to first row, pressed means the column will pull down. Suppose if the 7th one is pressed means this column is 0. Based on the switch contact, it will recognize the key, that is the key 7 is pressed. Similarly, when row 2 was selected, I am pressing 5. This column is enabled. Okay. So based on the logic low, the 5 pressed 5 key is recognized by your microcontroller. So we can detect the pressed key by using this technique. So this process is repeated for all the rows and columns. Okay. So here is the code for keypad and display. Okay. So the main aim of this program is whatever key I am pressing on the keypad, that should be displayed on LCD. Okay. So this is your main program. So already you are aware of your LCD command function. Okay. I have explained all your LCD command function and data function in the previous class. So first you have to enable your LCD display by passing some command hex codes. First you have to pass 38, 0E, 06 and 81 with some delays. Okay. So inside while I am passing LCD command 80, okay, this command is used to set cursor to blink at line 1 and position 1, okay. And second, after the command line of 80, I am sending some string. So for that I have written LCD string function for passing these characters, enter the key characters, okay. Just you look at this function. LCD, I have written separate function for displaying this string. Enter the key. Okay, so whatever key I am going to press, that will be displayed on your LCD. So this enter the key will be displayed on your LED. Okay, next I am passing the C7 hex code. So this is used to set cursor to blink at line 2, position 7. Okay. And after that, I am calling this keypad function. So this is a very important function for keypad interfacing. So please look at this function. First line, I am assigning high to all the columns, which means that I have configured the particular port line as input port, output port. Okay. Sorry, input port. Okay. Please look at here. Three control lines, these control lines for your LCD, and data pin is assigned to P2, okay. And I am using 4 row lines and column lines, and P1.0 to 1.3 are connected to, that is your row R1 to R4 are connected to 1.0 to 1.3, and column lines of keypad are connected to 1.4 to 1.7. So you have to configure this column lines as output lines, okay? Sorry, input lines, sorry. So you write 1, 2 individual pins, C1, C2, C3 and C4, okay? And after that, I'm assigning first row as 0 and keep remaining rows as high. That is R1 is 0, remaining R rows will be 0, which means that your R1 is selected. Okay. And next, I am checking for first column is 0 or not. Okay. If C1 is 0 or not. Okay. If it is 0, I should wait until the button is pressed. Then I can know the pressed key. Please look at this diagram. So here, so this is your row. So first row is selected and your column output is 0. Okay. So I am checking for first column is 0 or not. Okay. If it is 0, I should wait until the button is pressed. If I am going to press this seventh button means this row line will receive logic low signal. So based on that, I can know the pressed key. Okay. So that is the concept. So I am checking for C1 is equal to 0. If C1 is equal to 0 means I am going to display the data on LCD. So the pressed button is 7. So the 7 is going to be displayed on LCD. Okay. Next, else if I am checking for C2 is equal to 0, next column, I have to wait until the keypad is pressed. If the keypad is pressed, I can know the key. So that 8 will be displayed on the LCD. Similarly for C3, C4 and C4, 7, 8, 9 and division. So 7, 8, 9 and division. So now the first row is completed. So second case, second row will be selected. I'm keep on checking C1, C2, C3 and C4. Okay, so like that I am checking all the rows and columns. If the no key is pressed in the row, then I am making row 2 as 0. Row 2 is there, remaining rows are high. Similarly, next case, row 3, 0, remainings are 1. Next, row 4, 0. Then repeat the steps for all the rows. Okay. So this is for your register selection, write and enable. And this part is for configuring your input and output lines. The rows are configured as input lines, output lines, and columns are configured as input line. And this routine is for delay. And this function is, I have already explained the LCD display. So you have to pass the command by using this LCD command function. Next one is for displaying the data function. So every time you have to pass the character that should be attached to your P2. So this function is used to display the data on LCD, and this is for displaying your string. It is enter the key string, and this function is a very important function. So initially your port pins are configured as input port lines. First R1 is selected and checking for individual columns C1, C2, C3 and C4. Based on the logic low pulse, the particular data will be transferred to your LCD data function. So repeat the steps for all the rows. That's all about your keypad and LCD interfacing. So the program is compiled successfully. Now we can test it in Proteus. So this is the circuit once again. So all the columns, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 are connected to P. And rows are connected to 1.0 to 1.4. And already I have explained this LCD connection. Okay. So your data lines are connected to P2 of your microcontroller. Okay. So your keypad is connected to P1, that is rows are connected to 1.0 to 1.3 and columns are connected to 1.4 to 1.7 and 6x2 LCD data pins are connected to P2. Okay. Suppose if I press this one, once again. So the string is displayed on LCD, that is being displayed on LCD, enter the key. Now I am pressing this key 7, or 7 is displayed. So if any key is pressed, it waits until the key is released, okay? And returns the corresponding character on LCD. So this program is for single character display. Next time pressing 8. Pressing or division symbol. So using this circuit, you can design calculator, okay? Include some mathematical and logic operation to perform the mathematical operation, because we have division, multiplication, subtraction, and addition symbols. So we can design a simple calculator by using keypad and display. So you can modify this coding for continuous character display also, okay? So based on the column output, it will trace out the key based on the row output. Actually, when the key is pressed, means that key receives logic low signal. Every time your microcontroller will trace the row and column parallelly. If the logic level is low, means that key is recognized by your microcontroller. So that's all about your keypad and LCD interfacing. So your third unit is completed here. I am planning to conduct open book test for unit 3. Okay. So I will post the question in the Google Classroom and complete the answer sheet and complete and submit the answer sheets and submit the answer sheets on or before Sunday. That is November 1. Any clarification? I have covered all the topics in third unit. Any clarifications in third unit?